Imagine you were on a flight at 35,000 feet. Suddenly, there was a loud bang and the oxygen mask drop, passengers scream and the plane nosedive. This isn't some Hollywood movie. It's the stark reality of GPS spoofing. In December 2024, an Azerbaijan Airlines aircraft crashed into Kazakhstan, killing 38 passengers. Similar incidents have occurred around the world. Hi, I'm Avijit, and today we'll explore how technology can lead us to danger and how our civil aviation is under threat. So what is GPS spoofing? GPS spoofing is a tactic used to deceive the navigation system by sending out a false signal and thereby incorrect locations. It's a serious threat to aviation, to shipping, and to even personal navigation. This can cause a dangerous situation like aircraft veering off into a restricted zone or a ship being misled into a dangerous area. Understanding and mitigating this risk are crucial for our today's over-tech reliant world. Let's understand what is a GPS signal. The GPS satellite sends out two different kind of a signal. One is a P code used by the US military, and another one is a CA code or course acquisition code, which is widely used in the civilian sector. These are radio signals and actual data rides on these radio frequencies. As the CA code is openly published as a public specification, any adversary can spoof the data, recreate a spoofed version of it, and then transmit it back. You see, the GPS satellites are 20,000 kilometers away in the space and their signals are kind of weak. So anybody can create a very powerful transmission closer to the home. So most of the time, GPS receivers are unable to tell the difference between a real weak GPS signal and a very strong, powerful spoofed signal. So the receivers will calculate the position as per the spoofed signal and show a wrong location. Now, spoofing is nothing new. US military does it regularly during wartime scenario. They also used to induce an error into the satellite itself, and that used to be known as selective availability, but that has been withdrawn long time back, at least officially. There is also a second type of danger, and they are called GPS jamming. Now, the GPS jammers, they do not replicate the satellite signals, but they use a radio frequency strong enough to interfere with the GPS signals. And by jamming, they interfere with the positioning, navigation, and timing. These RF transmitting devices are relatively small and simple device, and they emit a radio signal as the same frequency of the GPS signals. And these jamming devices interfere with the GPS devices so much that the GPS devices are unable to calculate the position. Now, spoofing is done intentionally, but jamming can be either intentional, accidental, or maybe sometimes even natural. You do not want to be victim of either of them. So what can be done? How thousands of flights are still operating in relative safety? So while most of the newer GPS devices are anti-jamming and anti-spoofing, there are some anti-jamming devices are also available in the market. You need a different antenna to boost the signal-to-noise ratio to eliminate jamming frequencies. You need a high-gain antenna, adaptive filter, and modulation to neutralize the jamming. I have a link in the description below where you can read more about GPS jamming and anti-jamming. But what can you do about spoofing? GPS P code is almost immune to spoofing, but they are only for the US military use. Civilian aircrafts and vessels should use multiple constellation and differential augmented services. GNSS systems like US Navstar constellation, Russian GLONASS, Chinese BeiDou, and European Galileo systems. Using multiple constellation satellites that uses different frequencies is a good way to get rid of the spoofing. Wide area augmented services like EGNOS, EMSAS, and GAGAN can be really useful against the spoofing. Using INS system, along with gyroscope and accelerometer and even magnetometer can aid in anti-spoofing. If you want to know more about the INS system, then you should watch this video next. Be safe, spread knowledge, not garbage, and always be curious.